Did you guys know that Facebook has their own space program? Nowadays, it seems like every mega billionaire has their eyes on space. Zuckerberg has actually been in the space scene for a decent amount of time now, having started Facebook's space program in 2014. But unfortunately, like Blue Origin, it doesn't seem like Zuckerberg has much to show after several years of work. So what happened to Zuckerberg's space program? Well, unlike the traditional space companies that we are used to, it doesn't seem like Facebook has any ambitions to actually build and launch a rocket themselves. Facebook is more focused on what can be accomplished using rockets as opposed to the rockets themselves. This focus has led to three primary projects, which are a drone-based internet service, a satellite-based internet service, and a space probe capable of traveling 1/5 the speed of light. Starting with the drone-based internet service, Facebook initially announced this project in 2014 in conjunction with their new connectivity lab. The connectivity lab was created by hiring ex-NASA and ESA employees, and the lab was tasked with working on the internet.org project. This project was a partnership between seven major corporations, including Facebook, Samsung, Ericsson, MediaTek, Nokia, Opera, and Qualcomm. The goal of their project was to bring affordable internet access to the 5 billion people around the world who didn't have it at the time. Each company in the partnership had a specific role within the project. The smartphone companies had the task of implementing special antennas into their smartphones that could access the new internet service. The other tech companies had the role of improving data compression by making it cheaper and more efficient, and Facebook had the role of designing and launching the internet drones themselves. This internet.org project was eerily similar to Google's Project Loon. The only difference between the two projects is that Facebook proposed to use drones, while Google proposed to use a network of balloons. Both of these solutions sound super cool in theory, but they also seem super impractical and pointless. Why were these companies messing with the drones and balloons when they could just launch satellites to provide internet service? Satellites can leverage the gravitational force of the Earth to basically infinitely orbit around the Earth with no effort from the satellite. Drones, on the other hand, have to constantly run their engines to maintain altitude. While the latter option is a much more inefficient solution, it shines in two areas, which are cost and accessibility. Even for SpaceX, each satellite ends up costing hundreds of thousands of dollars, not to mention the cost of the rocket launch. Meanwhile, flying drones will likely only cost thousands of dollars each. If anything, it might cost tens of thousands, which is still only a fraction of the cost of launching a satellite. Aside from being much cheaper, the internet service offered by the drone network will be accessible by significantly more devices. Nowadays, smartphones are the easiest and cheapest way to access the internet. Because of this, entry-level internet users, especially in third-world countries, are much more likely to have a smartphone than a computer. So, providing mobile internet service is more effective than broadband service when trying to reach individuals with no internet access. And here's the thing, even the top flagship phones do not have the ability to communicate with satellites in space. So, it would be foolish to think that people in third-world countries have smartphones that can access satellite internet. Considering all of this, the reason Facebook was launching drones instead of satellites is because drone-based internet would provide internet that is much cheaper and much more accessible to the lowest tier of internet users. Unfortunately though, this ambition wouldn't quite pan out. In the summer of 2016, Facebook would conduct the first flight test of their solar-powered drone. This test was actually a massive success and was quite promising. The test flight was only supposed to last 30 minutes, but it would end up flying for 90 minutes. Now, the goal was to have the drone eventually fly 90 days at a time, but this was a great start. The same cannot be said about the landing though. A strong gust of wind combined with software issues would lead to one of the wings scraping on the ground and a 20-foot section breaking off. Facebook would end up correcting this mistake in their second test flight, which nailed the landing. But for some reason, Facebook would decide to scrap the drone altogether and shut down their manufacturing plant in 2018. This doesn't mean that Facebook gave up on drone-based internet though. They simply ditched trying to make their own drone. Instead, they would partner with Airbus in November of 2017. Since then, we have heard about a couple of test flights here and there, but aside from that, there really hasn't been many progress updates. It's assumed that the companies are perfecting the drone, and if things go well, we could see a beta rollout within the next couple of years. Moving on, we have Facebook's plan with satellite internet. This sector really needs no explanation. With satellite internet, Facebook is looking to provide broadband internet service to second-tier internet users. These people usually already have broadband internet or at least mobile internet, but their connection isn't the best. So Facebook, along with SpaceX, Blue Origin, and OneWeb, are looking to provide cheaper, faster, and more reliable internet access to these people. Since Facebook doesn't have launch capability though, they have to rely on rocket companies to launch their satellites. Ironically, one of their first satellite launches was in conjunction with SpaceX, and this launch happened to be one of SpaceX's only failures. Since then though, Facebook has successfully built up a constellation of 53 small satellites, and they hope to launch a broadband service in the imminent future. I'm not too sure how successful such a service will be though. Facebook will likely have a tough time matching the prices offered by Starlink, since they don't launch their own satellites. Facebook also doesn't have a massive subscriber base that they can leverage. For instance, it looks like Jeff Bezos and Amazon will be late to the satellite game. But when they do enter, it looks like they're positioned to become the second largest satellite internet provider. Not only would Jeff Bezos have launch capability with Blue Origin, but he can also leverage his massive Prime subscriber base. I feel like people would either just go with SpaceX to support their mission, or just go with Amazon because it's convenient. So, I'm not quite sure why someone would choose Facebook or OneWeb over the competition. But that's just what I think. Let me know if you guys disagree. Anyway, that brings us into Facebook's final and likely their most exciting project called Breakthrough Starshot. Zuckerberg founded this project in April of 2016 with Stephen Hawking and Russian billionaire Yuri Milner. The goal of the project is to send probes to planets with liquid water. These planets are often called Goldilocks zone planets. The fact that the water is liquid proves that the planet is not too cold or too hot. According to Zuckerberg, planets that don't have liquid water aren't that useful for human inhabitation. He previously wrote, quote, "Mars has no water, so it would be difficult to ever live there." Elon Musk and his fans would likely disagree with this notion, but it is true that terraforming Mars into an Earth-like planet would take thousands and thousands of years. Zuckerberg claims that it's quite possible the closest planet that humans could actually live on is orbiting Alpha Centauri, and the only way to know that for sure is to visit close enough to photograph the planet, which is what this project will do. The only problem with this idea is that Alpha Centauri is 4.3 light years away, or about 25 trillion miles away. Even if we use the fastest spacecraft we have today, it would take 30,000 years to get there according to Zuckerberg. But one of the main reasons for such a long travel time is the large mass of the spacecraft. Newton's basic second law states that force equals mass times acceleration. So if you decrease the mass substantially, you can significantly increase acceleration and get much closer to the speed of light. And this is precisely what Zuckerberg plans to do. Advancing technology has made it possible to manufacture extremely small cameras and sensors, and Zuckerberg wants to build nanoprobes called nanocraft. As the name suggests, a nanoprobe is an optical device that measures as little as just 100 nanometers in length. To put that in perspective, you could fit 100 million nanoprobes within a single square millimeter. It's unlikely that Zuckerberg's nanocraft will be that small, but that gives you a reference as to how small nanoprobes can get. Given the extremely small mass of such devices, Zuckerberg is hoping to launch his probes using a laser beam that will launch his probes at 1/5 the speed of light. That's the same as 134 million miles per hour or 60 million meters per second. Even at that speed though, it's going to take quite a bit of time to actually reach Alpha Centauri. Zuckerberg expects that his nanocraft can reach Alpha Centauri within 20 years after launch. And once there, the nanocraft should be able to identify any signs of liquid water and extraterrestrial life on any of the planets. At the end of the day, it's no question that space is the next big venue of growth. So it's not surprising that billionaires are crowding into the space. So far, Zuckerberg has been working with Airbus to deploy cheap mobile internet and rocket companies to deploy cheap broadband internet. Looking forward, Zuckerberg is determined to find the closest signs of liquid water and alien life with his nanocraft. Despite the setbacks in all of these projects, Zuckerberg has continued to persist forward. But only time will tell which one of these endeavors, if any, will evolve into something much bigger. Do you guys think Zuckerberg has a real chance? Comment that down below. Also, drop a like if you guys love seeing the growing interest in the space industry. And of course, consider joining our Discord community to suggest future video ideas, and consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.